Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and welcome to our first day of flight and space training. I want you to open up Chrome, and I want you to type Tinkercad in the browser window. And when you get to Tinkercad, we are going to sign in using our social providers. Make sure you just click sign in. When the little window pops up, make sure you choose this button, and then choose your Google account, and bam, you will be in Tinkercad for the first time. Tinkercad most likely will put you in this tutorial. I don't want you to do it though. I want you to instead click the Tinkercad dashboard and return to the very first page so we can create a new design. Once you hit create new design, it will open the actual window and we can start building. Today's build is going to be fast and fun. I want you to start by changing the name of our file. Let's call it FS for flight and space, and then put our name after it. I've got mine up here as Mike. You guys will have your name, and then we need to start building our parts. So this is the work plane, and I want you to grab a roof and I want you to drop it on the work plane. It's got a rotation handle that is easier to grab if you look at it from a corner. So I click the view cube, and then I can grab that red handle. And if I move my mouse way away, it goes 1 degree at a time. If I stay close, it uses those longer tick marks and goes 22.5 degrees at a time. I want you to get it so that it's perpendicular to the work plane. And then I want to show you these black handles. If you stretch them, they only move in one direction. If you use a white handle, it goes in two directions at a time. I don't want that, so I'm going to do undo, which is also Control Z. I am going to grab this white handle, which is the up and down handle, and I'm going to look at it from the front so you can tell for sure that I'm showing you up and down, and I'm going to raise it up a crazy number, but then I want you to click the box and type the number 20. What we have just done is we've made a nameplate. Right now with my mouse, I am right-click rotating. You can also grab the view cube and rotate, or just click on those combinations like the front to get a better view of it. I want you to put your name right on this. Let me show you the cool way that you can do it. If you click the word work plane and you click on the green edge, the next piece that you bring out there, for instance the text, will land right on that shape. I'm going to go back to the plane work plane by clicking here and then just clicking the ground. You can see that better if we click from a corner. So work plane, and I'm going to click the old blue work plane, and look at that. The word text is on the screen. With those words on the screen, now we can click where it says text, and then we can change this box to say our name. Please put your name in the box. I'm going to backspace over where it said text, and I'm going to throw in the mic. And then if you want to shrink and adjust it, we need to get back to that work plane. So let's just click the green edge again, and then it lets us use these black handles to just stretch our name and make it exactly the way we want. Also, we can change the thickness. If we look at it from the right, you can see that that is crazy thick. I'm going to actually switch to the right corner, and instead of 10, we could drag it to any number, or we could drag it a little and then type in the box 2 millimeters so that it looks the way you want. Once again, I'm going to put the work plane back to the flat edge, and now I'm going to pick my favorite colors. I'm going to go gray for the big piece, and I'm going to go blue for the words. Just like that, you've got it arranged beautiful. I want to make sure that it's centered, so I'm going to drag and grab both of those, and I'm going to click on the center tool. Boom. Just like that, I have got a nameplate. I'm going to take those two pieces and I'm going to group them. Now note when I do that, it turns all one color. Check this out. There is a cool multicolor option so you can bring back your colors. And now we've got a cool little nameplate and have learned some sweet basic skills in Tinkercad. So my friends, remember we are in flight and space, so let's actually make an airplane super quick. First, let's bring out a cylinder and set it on our screen and then change its measurements. I want you to click on this little dude and I want you to hold down shift and make him grow quite a bit. Whatever number you do put, I want you to change it to 15 and press enter, and that way it actually shrinks to that same measurement on every side. I would like our airplane to be round, so I want you to take the number of sides, and I want you to stretch it out so we have what's called a round fuselage or a body. We need it to be longer, so now without holding shift, I want you to simply stretch this one out and then type the number 60 in the little box. So what we have is a 6 centimeter tall fuselage. Let's make sure we're looking at it from the front corner. And let's take this rotation handle and let's bring the mouse close to the shape and lay it flat. If you go way away from it, notice it goes 1 degree at a time. If you stay close, it snaps to those nice little longer tick marks. When you've got it lined up like this, I would like you to hit the letter D and drop it to that work plane. Right there we have got the body of our airplane, or the fuselage. Let's add a front to our airplane by clicking that work plane, which is the letter W if you're looking for a shortcut, and let's add a nose to our cool airplane. You could use the cone or you could use the paraboloid, but I simply want you to drop it close. And then remember how this was 15 on every side? We want to hold down shift, stretch it to a crazy size, and then type 15 and press enter so that it actually fits. Let's put that work plane back on the ground. And if you look, I am right click rotating. They are not lined up. To line them up, simply draw a box that touches both. So it says two shapes selected. And then we want to center it. And then we want to put them to the bottom, or if we centered them, see, that'd be floating. So we want them on the bottom. Just like that, you've got the nose of the airplane, and because of the work plane, it was connected, and you've got the fuselage. This first plane is just going to be fun, and we're going to use basic skills. Later, we'll make a much more epic one in Tinkercad as well. Right now, let's add a cockpit using the half sphere. Simply drop the half sphere on your work plane, stretch it out a little bit, maybe make it a little skinnier because remember we are only 15 wide, so I'm going to go 12, and then shrink it a little bit. I'm going to grab all of those pieces and I'm going to align them. I really want you to get good at using this tool, so I want them aligned in the center, and then I'm going to click on the pink one and I'm going to use the arrow keys to nudge it where I want. So I think I want the person's little canopy to be right there. And then watch this. If you do control and tap the up arrow, it lifts it up until you've got it to the exact spot you want. If you let go of control, then you can do your left and right to move it where you want it on your airplane. If you accidentally lose the centering, you can just select them all again. And remember, we want them centered on that line. A really cool thing you can do is make it so that people can see in it by making it transparent. So now it actually looks like the bubble canopy where a pilot would sit. Let's bring out a simple wedge for a wing. And then let's take this wing and rotate it 90 degrees. Once again, staying close to the shape so it's easy to snap. Let's make it real thin, like 5 or 4 millimeters. I'll let you pick. Let's move it over to the side where we want it and then stretch it so it looks the way you want using those slick little black handles. When you've got it just the way you want, click on the duplicate button to make a second one. Use the arrow keys to move it to the other side and then use the awesome flip tool to simply flip it so that it looks the way you want. To make sure it's lined up really perfectly, click on the fuselage and choose hide. And then draw a box that just touches those two wing pieces, which had a pretty decent separation, and group them. Now when we use show all, if you draw a box that just touches the wings and the body, you can center them so you're sure they're lined up the way they're supposed to be. That messed up the nose and the rest of the plane, so I'm just going to grab all of the parts and I'm going to do that center again. Or we could have done undo. Either way, it would have worked. If we look at our airplane from the left, the wings look kind of funny down there on the bottom. So we can just click on them and do that control up trick to raise them up to a better height. That's a cooler place for a wing. You may want to make your wings a little thinner though. You can adjust that however it makes you happy. I'm gonna click on my fuselage, and instead of 60, I'm gonna push it out to 80, just cause it looks a little nicer that way. And now it's time to build the tail of my plane. Let's use a different piece. This time let's go down and find the whole roof, drop it on the screen, rotate it 90 degrees, and then also, let's look at it from a corner because that makes it easier, stand it up. Stay close to the shape so it's easy to get to that 90, and then this will be the tail of our airplane. Once again, I'm going to use the black handles to stretch it to what makes me happy. You can pick any numbers that you think look cool with your plane. And then I'm going to grab the entire project again, and let's use that align tool. We're going to use these again and again and again to get it so you feel comfortable. I can lift it with the cone. Sometimes I have found that it is easier to teach you to use the control up or control down so that you get exactly what you want. Let's look at it from the top, and you can see that that isn't quite where I want it in the back. So I'm going to just use the arrow key and nudge it so it's exactly where I want it. We need to add the tail fin. Let's do it with the cone. I want to hit work plane though first, which the shortcut is W, and I want to make sure that the cone I bring out lands on the green tail fin. Now you'll notice that this is a point, but check this out. If you click on the top of this and type a number 3, it all of a sudden is not a point anymore. And then we can make it look like a tail fin by squeezing it a little bit thinner and then using the same tricks we've used several times to center it so it's where the tail fin would actually be. I'm going to push it forward a little bit using the arrow keys. And I think I want to raise it up, so I'm going to do control up arrow to get it exactly where I want. Let's press W to get the work plane back to the ground and take a look at our awesome plane. Friends, there are lots of cool things you can do at this point to make yours more and more epic. You could hit the W and add words to the wing. You could add words to the side. You could put stars on it. You have got all kinds of skills at this time that you can use to decorate your cool airplane. And what's most awesome about it is if you go back to the main Tinkercad dashboard, it is immediately saved. This is available to you on your Chromebooks. It's available to you on any device you make. You can see here, there are thousands of things I made. To get back in and tinker it again, if you wanted to do it from home, you simply hit tinker this and you are back in your project and ready to keep playing. If you're in my classroom, you may continue to have fun with it, but I do want you to remember that I do want a screenshot of it. When you're ready to take your screenshot, simply hit the Windows button and then type SNI for snipping tool. And when the snipping tool arrives, it will make your screen gray and you can grab a picture of your plane or your plane in your name. I am flexible. And then you can save that to your documents. Just make sure you give it a name so you know which one it is. I'm going to call mine FS Mike and put it in my documents. And once you've got that all done, you can then turn in that screenshot in Google Classroom. Alrighty, friends, so there is so much room for you to have more fun with this. You can see I added some cool flames and a little jet engine and some pods under the wings. You can add wheels. You can do all kinds of things. You have got some of the basic skills now to do incredibly cool things. The one thing I'd like to show you before I send you away is if you click on one piece, you can use this very cool fit view to shape. It takes you right to it, and then you can just zoom back to home when you're done. And that is a good way to maneuver around as you're building your cool projects. If you enjoyed the video, my friends, please give it a like. If you got a question, comment, or a suggestion, add it down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit the notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.